Well, this is our breeding pair of Mangalitsa pigs, Porky and Petunia.
They are a Hungarian heritage breed known for their delicious lard and their buttery soft meat.
So some of you know, if you've been here a while, that we have a breeding pair of Mangalitsa hogs, and we have yet to have any piglets, even though we've had them for over a year. So the vet suggested that before we harvest either one of them, we have to figure out which one of them is not doing their job. So today we are taking Porky to my nephew's house, and my nephew has a gilt as well. So we're gonna give Porky the chance to father some piglets with my nephew's gilt. So Petunia is gonna go back into the woods this spring, and she's gonna live happily in the woods by herself, like she likes it. And Porky's gonna go visit a new girl. Petunia, when we come back, you'll get to go to the woods again. This is Porky. I better close up so he doesn't try to jump out.
Here we are, arriving at my nephew's little farm.
This is Wilbur. You're a big mama. Do you smell Porky?
Huh? Oh yeah. He's pretty tame.
Yeah.
She's pretty spoiled, isn't she? What's your horse's name?
Harmon.
There we go.
Okay, so this is my nephew Jeffrey, and he's gonna tell the kids how Wilbur came to be his pig.
So, 2 summers ago, this would be going on the 3rd year now, I was biking home from work, and there was a car stop on the other side of the road facing me, and I stopped to see what was going on, and this guy was chasing a little baby pig through the ditch, and so I caught it, and I asked him if he wanted it, and he said nope, he doesn't know what to do with it. So actually, I had my tractor that day. That's how I took her home. I grabbed her and took her with me in the cab, took her home, and raised her up. So she was unharmed. I don't know. My first guess was she somehow got out of a pig truck when she was being delivered to a hog barn, but I don't understand that she wasn't scraped, scratched, or banged up. And yeah, almost 3 years later, she is a big, healthy pig.
And although it's a she, her name is Wilbur.
Yes.
After the pig from Charlotte's Web.
That's exactly right. It just fit too good.
So the reason we have them separated is because pigs aren't quite like cows. It takes them a little bit to accept each other, and we don't want them to get into a fight. So we have separated them so they can get used to each other before we give them full access to each other.
So we're back at home and bringing Petunia to her summer pasture in the woods.
Come, Petunia! Come, girl! Come on, girl!
Thank you.
brought you a treat. You want it?
Petunia also gets all the whey that we have left over after making cheese. This is Ralph, a little rooster that was a gift to us a number of years ago. He roams the barnyard and thinks he's the king of the barnyard. The turkeys are now full grown. They pick up any grain that the cows leave behind. And we've recently started finding a few turkey eggs every week. There's not much happening in the garden yet. It's snowed a couple times since we planted seeds in the cold frame. But inside the cold frame, our lettuce and radishes and cabbages have sprouted, along with a couple dandelions too. The rhubarb has started peeping through the soil as well.